إن الحمد لله، نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته، ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة، وخلق منها زوجها، وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله عز وجل، وأحسن الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألهى، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. ثم أما بعد، all praise is due to Allah. We praise Him and we seek His aid and forgiveness. And we seek refuge in Allah from the evils of ourselves and bad deeds. Whomsoever Allah guides, no one can mislead. And whomsoever Allah lead astray, there is no guidance for him. I bear witness and testify that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah. And I bear witness that Muhammad is His last messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All who have believed, fear Allah as He ought to be feared, and they not accept in the state of Islam. O mankind, be dutiful to your Lord, who created you from a single soul, and created from it its mate, and scattered from both many men and women. And fear Allah, to whom you demand your mutual rights, and have a good kinship relations. Indeed, Allah is always watching over you. O you who have believed, fear Allah, and speak always the truth. He will fix your deeds and forgive you your sins, and whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger will achieve a great success. Indeed, the most truthful book is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the best guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the worst matter is the innovation in the deen. And every innovation is misguidance. And every misguidance will be in the hellfire. And to proceed, my brothers and sisters in Islam, الأسباب الجالبة لمحبة الله عز وجل. The reasons that make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love His servants. In the previous khutbah, I mentioned the four reasons for the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الإمام ابن القيم رحمه الله mentioned in his book مدارج السالكين 10 reasons for the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the first reason we mentioned the last khutbah is to be the companion of the Quran. The companionship of the Quran is reason for the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second reason we spoke about is to do a lot of voluntarily actions of worship after you fulfill your obligations until Allah loves you. And the third reason is to favor what Allah loves over what you love. To favor what Allah loves over what you love. And the fourth reason is to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you have no interest in this dunya. If you show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that your interest is in akhirah and you are investing this dunya for akhirah, Allah will love you. And the fifth reason is to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with much remembrance. Allah azza wa jalla said in the Quran, فَاذْكُرُونِ أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ فَاذْكُرُونِ أَذْكُرْكُمْ. If you recite the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will praise you azza wa jalla. If you remember him, he will remember you subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you are grateful to him and thankful to him and not denying his right to be worshipped, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will love you azza wa jalla. I want every and each one of us to reflect upon this. فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. Imagine yourself when you sit to recite the remembrance of Allah, whether it is the Quran or you are sitting with yourself to recite at-tasbih, wa-tahmid, wa-tahleel, wa-takbir, that Allah Azza wa Jal is remembering you, is praising your action, is talking about what you are doing with His angels and those who live in heavens. Just to think about it. If you heard that the officials in the White House are talking about you or discussing your affairs, how you feel? If your affairs was a subject in a talk show on TV, how you think about this? If you posted something on social media and people paid attention to it, so they started to like and to share and to comment, how you think about this? When you are recognized by human being just like you. How about if the one who is talking about you is Allah Almighty? Think about it to know the value of reciting the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. So remember me, I will remember you. So your recitation of the remembrance of Allah, make Allah love you subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah azza wa jalla said in the Quran, وَالذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةً وَأَجْرٌ عَظِيمٌ. So those who recite the remembrance of Allah a lot, males or females, those who recite the remembrance of Allah as much as they are able, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةً وَأَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. Allah Azza wa Jal did prepare for them a great forgiveness and great compensation, great reward out of love. Because when you, one of those who recite the remembrance of Allah a lot, when you keep your tongue moist with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will love you. And if He loved you subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will forgive you. And if He forgave you subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will compensate you in the day of judgment, a great compensation subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is as easy as if you wake up during the night and wake up your wife to pray with you 2 rak'at during the night, Allah Azza wa Jal will write your name and her name among الذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات. It is not my opinion, it is a hadith. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in this hadith, and the hadith is reported in Sunan Abu Dawood, narrated by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu. He said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قام من الليل فأيقظ أهله فصلى ركعتين كتب في الذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات. If you woke up during the night and you have this righteous wife, that when you wake her up to
to pray with you two rak'at, she will do it. She will obey you and then pray with you. And once you pray together just two rak'at, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will register your names, both of you, among الذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said, everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala obligated us to do, He made limit for it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah Azza wa Jal commanded us to pray, but He limited the obligatory prayer to 5 prayers every single day. Allah Azza wa Jal commanded us to fast, and He limited the obligatory fasting to the month of Ramadan. Even to pay zakah from your money, it is limited to 2.5% if you have certain amount of money for a year. And it is like that even Hajj, it is only once in your lifetime. But when it came to the remembrance of Allah, Allah Azza wa Jal did not put limit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا هو الذي يصلي عليكم وملائكته ليخرجكم من الظلمات إلى النور وكان بالمؤمنين رحيما. O you who have believed, remember Allah with much remembrance. He did not say 5 times or 6 times or 1 time or once in your lifetime. He said much remembrance, because it's easy to do it with your tongue instead of cursing and backbiting and speaking only about dunya and gossiping. Just keep your tongue moist with the remembrance of Allah. O you who have believed, اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا, remember Allah with much remembrance. وسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا, praise Him and glorify Him in the morning and in the afternoon. Ibn Abbas said, صلاة الفجر وما بعدها من ذكر وصلاة العصر وما بعدها من ذكر. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to pray the Fajr prayer and to sit for the remembrance of Allah after Fajr, and to pray Asr prayer and to sit for the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at any time between Asr and Maghrib. Recite the remembrance, the morning remembrance, the afternoon remembrance. وسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا هو الذي يصلي عليكم وملائكته. So when you recite His remembrance, يصلي عليك. هو الذي يصلي عليكم وملائكته. It is He who confers His blessings upon you. And His angels ask Him to do so. Supplicate for Him to confers His blessings upon you. هو الذي يصلي عليكم وملائكته ليخرجكم من الظلمات إلى النور. إذا صلى الله عليك اهتديت. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala confers His blessings upon you, you will get out of the darkness to the light. You will get out of the darkness of shirk. You will get out of the darkness of innovations in the deen. You will get out of the darkness of the major sins. You will get out of the darkness of disobedience to the light of Tawheed and Sunnah, to the light of monotheism and the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You will get out of the darkness to the light. لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved 99% of His mercy for the believers in the Day of Judgment. For the believers in the Day of Judgment, for those who deserve this title, believers, Allah saved 99% of His mercy for them in the Day of Judgment, subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters, it is reported in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, and narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu. He said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الله تعالى أنا عند ظن عبدي بي وأنا معه إذا ذكرني. أنا عند ظن عبدي بي I am as my servant think of me. If you think that Allah is truthful in everything He told you, if you think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfills His promises and gives the rewards that He promised, you would be the way you think of Him. Exactly. I am the way my servant think of me. وَأَنَا مَعَهُ إِذَا ذَكَرَنِي. I am with him if he remembers me. Did you hear this? Allah is with you if you remember him. Wallahi, if you feel these two words with you, if you just feel it, if you think about it, that Allah is with you. Allah is with you. وَأَنَا مَعَهُ إِذَا ذَكَرَنِي. Once you remember Allah, Allah is with you. فَإِنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي نَفْسِهِ ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي نَفْسِي وَإِنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي مَلَأٍ ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي مَلَأٍ أَعْظَمُ مِنْهُ. If you remember Allah within yourself, between you and yourself, Allah will remember you with Himself, subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you remember Him with people, He will remember you with those who are better than these people. If you remember Allah among group of people in dunya, Allah will remember you and mention you in front of those who live in heavens, with the angels, with the prophets and the messengers, with the martyrs and the righteous believers. Imagine you sit with yourself to recite the Quran at home, or you sit to recite the tasbih and the tahmid and the tahleel and the takbir. Or you sit in a gathering to study the Quran and the Sunnah and to seek knowledge. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praise your action in front of the angels, in front of the prophets and the messengers, and every prophet hears about you. Not only Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Every martyr knows about you. Knows about the active servant who is reciting the remembrance of Allah. It tells us that repayment is from the same nature of your action. The way you treat Allah, He will treat you. If you remember Him, He will remember you. You remember Him within yourself, He will remember you within Himself. If you remember Him with people, He will remember you with people who are better than these people. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jalla said in this hadith Qudsi, وَإِذَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي شِبْرًا تَقَرَّبْتُ إِلَيْهِ ذِرَاعًا وَإِذَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ ذِرَاعًا تَقَرَّبْتُ إِلَيْهِ بَاعًا وَإِذَا أَتَانِي يَمْشِي أَتَيْتُهُ هَرْوَلَهُ. سبحان الله. Allah Azza wa Jal is saying, if you come close to Allah an inch length, He will come close to you an arm length. If you come close to Him a span, He comes closer to you cubit. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as much as you come, Allah comes more. Think about it. So whatever you want from Allah, just do it first. You want to feel the presence of Allah in your life? Be present. Be present in His remembrance. Sit for the remembrance of Allah, He will remember you. Come close with actions of righteousness. He will come closer. If you show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you want to be close to Him, He will show you how close He is, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will show you His love, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is one of the things that makes Allah loves you. Also, mushahadatu al-asma' wa-sifat hatta tatahaqqaq al-ma'iyyah. That you keep remembering the attributes of Allah until you feel the togetherness with him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you know that Allah is all seeing, Allah is all hearing, Allah is all knowing. You believe in that, but you are heedless of that. So you need to keep remembering and reflecting upon the attributes of Allah until you feel the togetherness. He will love you. So when you walk in your day and make decisions, while you remember that Allah is seeing you, Allah hears you, Allah knows what's in your heart, put it in your mind that you see the effect of your belief in every attribute on your actions, you will arrive to this level of togetherness. إِلَى مَعِيَّةِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. So that will make you a righteous person. That will make you pious. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran that He loves. He said, إِنَّ اللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ. إِنَّ اللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. اللَّهُ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ. اللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. اللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَوَكِّلِينَ. يحب الذين يقاتلون في سبيله صفا كأنهم بنيان مرصوص. So Allah loves those who repent all the time. Allah loves those who rely upon Allah. Allah loves those who are righteous, those who are pious, those who are obedient. So these verses from the Quran are telling us that Allah loves the person who has these qualities and the one who watch the attributes of Allah and believe in it until it affects his actions and decisions. Allah will love him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah also loves the one who watch the favors of Allah upon him. And he is thankful and appreciating Allah for that. When Allah gives you, Allah wants you to be thankful and to appreciate him. If you do, he will love you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. A lot of people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them health, but they don't appreciate it until they get sick. Then they ask. When they are okay, they don't know Allah. When they are healthy, they don't say, thank you Allah, that I'm able to see, I'm able to hear, I'm able to walk, I'm able to work. They don't say that until they need eyeglasses. So they think, thank you Allah. Right? When they are sick in the hospital, make dua for me. The Prophet said, تعرف إلى الله في الرخاء يعرفك في الشدة. Know Allah in the time of ease, He will know you in the time of hardship. Don't know Allah only when you are in trouble. Allah likes His servant who recognizes His favors and bounties and thank Him for it in the time of ease before the time of hardship. So when you know Allah in the time of ease, He will make you experience His love and His presence in the time of hardship. My brothers and sisters, also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the person who humble himself and worship submissively. انكسار القلب بين يديه. To be with a broken heart between His hands. You don't worship with arrogance. Because Allah does not like arrogant people. Allah likes the humble people. When you are down to earth, when you stand before Allah, while your heart is broken, you know your mistakes. You recognize His favors and you know your mistakes. You know how good He is to you and how bad you are to Him. So when you stand before Allah Azza wa Jalla with a broken heart, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you and give you strength and strengthen the iman in your heart. But don't stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you are making Him a favor. Because some of us, when they do something for the sake of Allah, they feel like they are making favor to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Wallahi al-azim. Wallahi al-azim, you can see some people, they do little. And they think that they are making big favor to Allah. They think they are big people in the sight of Allah. And as much as you see yourself big, you are small. If you see yourself small in the sight of Allah, if you see yourself small in the sight of Allah, little, whatever you do, still little. Allah deserves more. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will maximize your reward. He will recognize your action. And the one who is doing even righteous actions, but with arrogance, he is seeing himself as if he is making favors to Allah. Allah would see him and his actions little and small. My brothers and sisters in Islam, our Prophet taught us to say, Allahumma anta Rabbi, la ilaha illa ant. Oh Allah, you are my Lord. There is no deity except you. خلقتني وأنا عبدك. You have created me and I am your servant. وأنا على عهدك ووعدك ما استطعت. I am upon my covenant to you as much as I'm able. أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت. I seek refuge in you from the bad that I did. أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت. أبوء لك بنعمتك علي. I am appreciating your favors upon me. I'm recognizing your bounties upon me. أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي. I admit to my guilt. فاغفر لي. Oh my Lord, forgive me. إنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. No one forgives sins except you. See how Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is teaching us to speak to Allah with a broken heart, with humbleness, with submissiveness, not with arrogant. So when we are like that, Allah will love us. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه سميع قريب مجيب. الحمد لله وكفى وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على عبده المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم صل عليه وعلى آله وعلى كل من سار على منواله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد, my brothers and sisters, it is reported in Muwatta in Imam Malik and narrated by Abu Idris al-Khawlani. He said that he visited a big mosque, big masjid in Ash-Sham, Greater Syria. So inside the masjid he found a man sitting and a lot of people are asking him questions and he's answering every and each one of them. So he asked, who is this person? They said, Mu'adh ibn Jabal, sahib Rasulullah. He is Mu'adh ibn Jabal, the companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he said, I will come tomorrow to sit with him before anyone else. So Abu Idris came in the next day. He thought he'll be the first person in the masjid even before Mu'adh. But when he arrived, he found Mu'adh before him in the masjid. So Abu Idris went to Mu'adh and he told him, by Allah, I love you. I love you. So Mu'adh ibn Jabal told him, Allah, are you swearing by Allah that you love me? He said, Allah, I swear by Allah. So he asked him three times, are you swearing by Allah? Three times you told him, yes, I swear by Allah, I love you. He's a companion, one of the toughest scholars of the companions. So every Muslim loves him. So Mu'adh grabbed him from his clothes, very close to him, and told him, I asked you to swear because I have good news for you. What is it? He said, I heard the messenger of Allah saying, وجبت محبتي للمتحابين فيا.
والمتجالسين في والمتزاورين في والمتباذلين في.
He told him the love of Allah is a mandatory for the one who loves his Muslim brothers. If you love your Muslim brothers, Allah will love you. This is one of the ways for Allah to love you. If you want Allah to love you, love the believers. Love the believers for the sake of Allah. Not because one of them found a job for you or give you a loan before, or he's always praising you or making favors for, no, just for Allah. I love him because he's a believer. I love him because Allah told me to love him. So I do effort to love him. I will do the means to love him. Love the believers. Real love. Allah knows your heart. So if you love the believers, Allah will love you. You have no reason to love them except Allah. You sit with them because Allah told you that. اصبر نفسك مع الذين يدعون ربهم بالغداة والعشي يريدون وجهه. Allah told you in the Quran to make your friends the believers. So you sit with them because they are the believers. You visit them because they are the believers. You give them because they are the believers. Just to please Allah. Once you have Allah and reason for this, Allah will love you. Subhanallah. You know, the man who left his village walking to another village. So Allah sent an angel to him in the form of man to stop him, to ask him, where are you going? Said, I'm going to visit a friend of mine in the other village. So he told him, did he make any favor to you? So you are going to appreciate his favor. He said, no, I'm just going to visit him for the sake of Allah. So he said, Allah sent me to you to tell you that he loved you because of your love to your brother. In the hadith, authentic hadith, the Prophet said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ. The Prophet is swearing, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to assure us by the one who has his soul in his hand, Allah Almighty, that none of us will enter Jannah until he believes. لَا تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ حَتَّى تُؤْمِنُوا. There is no any other way not to believe the liars who are saying you could be mushrik and you go to Jannah. It's not going to work. Jannah is haram for the mushrikeen. They are liars. In the hadith, the Prophet said, no one will enter Jannah until he believes. And then he said, and your belief will not be complete until you love the believers. وَلَا تُؤْمِنُوا حَتَّى تَحَابُ. So your iman will never be complete until you love your Muslim brothers. And the Prophet said, أَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ إِذَا فَعَلْتُمُوهُ تَحَبَبْتُمْ أَفْشُوا السَّلَامَ بَيْنَكُمْ. Do I tell you about something, if you do it, you love one another, spread peace. Be peaceful person. So don't abuse anyone physically or attack his chastity or take his money or take his property. Don't do that because you are not peaceful when you do that. Be peaceful for people to love you. Do not show interest in what they possess. They will love you. Prophet Muhammad said that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, اذهب فيما عند الناس يحبك الناس. Don't show interest in what people possess. They will love you. So make it easy for each other to love one another. And make Allah is the reason. Three qualities, if you have them, Allah will make you taste the sweetness of Iman. Three qualities. ثلاث ما كنا فيه وجد بهن حلاوة الإيمان. أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما. If you have this quality, if you love Allah and His Messenger more than anything, and if you love the person, you love him only for the sake of Allah. وَيُحِبَّ الْمَرْءِ لَا يُحِبُّ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. If you love the person only for the sake of Allah, this is the cause of the love. وَأَنْ يَكْرَهَ أَنْ يَعُودَ فِي الْكُفْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ أَنْقَذَهُ اللَّهُ مِنْهُ كَمَا يَكْرَهُ أَنْ يُقْذَفَ فِي النَّارِ. You hate to go back to a state of disbelief, or to hate to go back to commit major sins the way you hate to go to hellfire. Exactly. So Allah will make you taste the sweetness of iman, taste the sweetness of his love subhanahu wa ta'ala. And final thing before I leave this platform, it is not proper to know that Allah is coming for you and you are not respecting and honoring this time. If you hear it, as it is reported in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, narrated by Abu Hurairah, that Allah Azza wa Jal comes down as it befits His Majesty, not the way the creation come down. Allah comes down the way it befits His Majesty. He is unique in His attributes. Don't have imagination. But it is mentioned in this authentic hadith in the highest level of authenticity that Allah comes down in the last third of the night to say subhanahu wa ta'ala, if there any person want to ask me, so I give him what he asked for. هَلْ مِنْ دَاعٍ فَأَسْتَجِيبَ لَهُ هَلْ مِنْ مُسْتَغْفِرٍ فَأَغْفِرَ لَهُ هَلْ مِنْ سَائِلٍ فَأُعْطِيَهُ. Allah asks subhanahu wa ta'ala, who are they, those who want to supplicate and ask? Where are they, those who are seeking my forgiveness? I will grant them my forgiveness. You know that Allah Azza wa Jal is telling you that He comes down for you without imagination. But He said, for you to know the meaning, He is very close to you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you are not preparing yourself for that. It's a problem. It's a problem. Because if you know that somebody you love, if you love somebody and you know that he came for you, what you do? You've been his reception, right? Now they announced that there is a man of a status arrived to Jersey City. You run and go there, right? Just a reciter came from Kuwait. People were not able to enter the place because they love him. They love his voice, right? He's a famous, right? So when you love somebody, you show up. When Sheikh Abdullah Kamil passed away, and we said the janaza in the park, have you ever seen the amount of people that you saw there before? Because people love him. It's a true sign that people love him. They want to make dua for him. So how about if you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is coming down for you? He's telling you that without imagination, without having picture in your mind. Because what applies to Allah do not apply to the creation. What apply to the creation do not apply to Allah. Allah is unique in His attributes. We don't know how he descended. But He said, for us to understand, He's closer. So we need to honor the time. And if you are not doing that, we need to rethink. Because once you show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala how much you honor the time that He's offering you, He will show you how much He honors you subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأسأل الله عز وجل أن يرزقنا حبه وحب من أحبه وحب كل عمل يقربنا إليه. اللهم إنا نسألك حبك وحب من أحبك وحب كل عمل يقربنا إليك. اللهم إنا نسألك حبك وحب من أحبك وحب كل عمل يقربنا إليك. اللهم اشرح صدورنا، اللهم طهر قلوبنا، اللهم احفظ فروجنا، اللهم ردنا جميعا إلى دينك مردا جميلا. اللهم أصلحنا وأصلح أزواجنا وأولادنا واجعلنا صالحين مصلحين. اللهم اهدنا واهد أزواجنا وأولادنا واجعلنا هداة مهتدين. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا برحمتك يا خير الراحمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين وهب المسيئين منا للمحسنين. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم إنا نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والسلامة من كل إثم والغنيمة من كل بر والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا وعملا صالحا متقبلا ورزقا حلالا طيبا. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار.
اللهم أعتق رقابنا من النار بفضلك وجودك يا رب العالمين. اللهم أعتق رقابنا من النار بفضلك وجودك يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر عبادك المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم كل المسلمين في فلسطين ولا تكن عليهم. اللهم كن معهم ولا تكن ضدهم. اللهم انصرهم على عدوك وعدوهم. اللهم من أرادنا والإسلام والمسلمين بخير فوفقه إلى كل خير، ومن أرادنا والإسلام والمسلمين بشر فاجعل كيده في نحره، واجعل تدبيره تدميره، واجعل الدائرة عليه يا رب العالمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله. أقم الصلاة.